Welcome to a new lesson. Today, let us understand how to calculate the value of unsold inventory with the consignee. Let us take up this exercise. 1000 units are consigned at a cost of 20 each. The consignor pays 200 for insurance in transit and 300 for packing. The consignee pays 700 for freight, 300 for import duty. He also pays 200 as godown rent and 150 for local promotion. Consignee sold only 800 units at 30 each. Consignee is paid 6% commission. You are required to calculate the value of unsold inventory. Please note, this exercise is also given in the description below. So before we start calculating the value of unsold inventory, let us analyze this exercise. So we need to collect little information. These are number of units consigned multiplied by cost price. Number of units remaining with the consignee. Consignor's direct expenses. Consignee's direct expenses. Here, you need to pay an attention. Consignor's direct expenses and consignee's direct expenses. Then we calculate value of unsold inventory. So by looking at the exercise, let us gather information. Number of units consigned multiplied by cost price. It is 1000 times 20. Number of units remaining with the consignee, it is 200. Consignor's direct expenses, it is 200 plus 300, 500. Consignee's direct expense, 700 plus 300, 1000. What is the value of unsold inventory? Now we have to use a simple formula. The formula is cost price of goods sent plus consignor's direct expenses plus consignee's direct expenses divided by total number of units consigned multiplied by total number of units remaining. So now let us have figures. 1000 units consigned at the rate of 20 each plus consignor's expense 500, consignee's expenses 1000 multiplied by number of units consigned 1000 and number of units remaining 200. So if you simplify, the value of this is 4300. So this is the value of unsold inventory remaining with the consignee. One important note, while calculating the value of unsold inventory, indirect expenses of both the consignor and consignee are not taken into account. I repeat, indirect expenses of both consignor and consignee are not taken into account. So in this exercise, godown rent and local promotion paid by the consignee are not included as they are indirect expenses, including consignee's commission. Is that clear? Thank you. Have a great day.